AR-77 is a single-load shotgun unlocked at level 1, and it hits harder than my dad. Costing only 66 hunt dollars, it isn't rare to find this thing being used in the bayou. With a base damage of 218, one-shot kills are super common, as long as you stay below 14 meters. Your rate of fire and cycle time both take a while, and that's because this weapon can only hold one shell. Speaking of shells, be careful with your ammo usage. Like long ammo, you only get a few shells each time you loot an ammo resupply, so try not to go hog wild. The Romero spread is at 50. Keep in mind that hunt shotgun reticles are weird. The crosshairs lie to you and are much larger than the actual spread. This is by design, don't ask me why. It's not entirely game breaking, just aim with the center. Sway isn't bad at all, being 77. That's the same as the Winfield. When it comes to the recoil, however, yikes. Yeah, this really shouldn't be an issue though, given the fact that you have to reload after every shot. It takes 3.5 seconds to get a new shell in the gun, and it's the 4-second cycle time. The velocity is 450 meters per second, and that's faster than you'll ever need it to be. You won't be shooting people that far, unless you have brain damage. Penetration through one wood wall doesn't lose any damage. After two wooden walls, you can still get a one-shot kill, but you both have to be right next to the wall for it to happen.
You gotta be right next to me for it to look real. You gotta be right next to me.
Metal walls, don't even try. Let's hop in a game, shall we? My team and I run up to King Snake Mine, and one of them gets dropped. So, I get revenge. Get closer to the main building, and another enemy comes running. I kill them too.
Nice.
The last enemy hunter puts up an incredible fight. Whatever. I got 2 kills. Next variant. At a reduced price of 20 bucks, you can get yourself the Romero 77 hand cannon. Its barrel and stock have been shortened, taking it down to a 2-slot weapon instead of a 3. This means that you're going to see the stats drop in almost every category. Damage is reduced about 70 points, one-shot range goes down to 11 meters, spread and sway are both twice as bad, less notably, recoil is increased by 10, and velocity drops 75 meters per second. Cycle time is 0.2 seconds better, for some reason. Listen, as long as you stay close to your opponents, this thing will still be serviceable. Treat it like what it is, a shotgun. Don't go attempting cross-room shots and get mad you didn't one-shot somebody. There's a special ammo called Star Shell that you can use in the Romeros. It's just a shootable flare. Brighten up a dark room.
Not that bright, bro.
Oh yeah, I surely can't see you. Yeah.
Ignite red barrels. Kill AI, or let every nearby hunter be aware of your presence. Personally, I see no use for this ammo. Another ammo type that you'll get some more use out of is the Dragon Breath. Using this decreases your damage, range, spread, and velocity by considerable amounts. You won't be one-shotting hunters often with this, but you'll burn their health bars away pretty fast. If you want to raise some hell, bring it along. In a solo game, I tracked down an enemy duo. They became aware and popped shots at me. Deciding I didn't want to run anymore, I stood my ground and got ready for a fight.
Are you running, boy?
You're scaring me!
Oh, come on now.
Stop it!
Slow gunfight.
Stop it!
What kind of guns you got over there?
2 Romeros.
Ooh, spicy. Fuck, carries 2 Romeros.
I'm doing a video.
Ugh!
Shut up, bitch. The other guy just, like, spontaneously combusted.
What? What happened? What? Is there someone else here?
I don't know, it was weird. Anyways, I killed and banished Scrapbeak. I killed a duo of intruders. And then extracted. Yeah, so the Romero Talon is just the normal Romero, but it's got a saw thingy on the stock of the weapon. This gives you a massive damage-dealing heavy attack that's a one-hit kill almost every time. Your recoil and velocity take a small hit, but it's negligible. Is an $18 price increase worth it? I mean, I think so. It gives you another option if you miss your only shot, meaning you're less vulnerable. There's a special ammo called Penny Shot, and it replaces your pellets with coins. You get a small damage decrease, a slight range increase, and a large spread increase. These stats can be misleading, so try not to focus on them too much. The real takeaway here is that the coins you shoot out do more damage than pellets, but you also get less of them. I brought Seth along for a few games, and it went as well as you'd expect it to.
All right. We running 50 FPS.
All right.
It's worth it for the 4K. All right. In my dreams, whenever I'm swimming, I can't stop. It's been like that since like I was 16. I got penis shot ammo on this one.
Penis shot.
Flare on this one. I'm about to slam them.
Actually, it's called Star Shell, so.
Can't take it. Star Shell's OP in battle. You are sleeping on the star shell.
Okay, Bill.
Just bring fusies and take up a fucking pool slot, dude. Are you kidding me? I would rather take up a one little special ammo slot. Are you serious? You get two on a fucking hand.
You fucking brought fuses anyways. There are fuses in your inventory right now. Seth, come here. Come on.
You can never have too much.
Buddy, get with the program here.
You can never have too much. Oh my god, it's such an easy shot! And...
Damn.
Apparently he saw me. Alright, hit the res. He can't break through that. Hit the res, bro. Hit the res, I dare you.
I heard him open the door over there.
That's irrelevant. You missed, you fool! Talon the shit out of him! He doesn't have a shotgun, he has a fucking, what is it? Oh god, Kirk has a Winfield! Oh god!
Reference. Don't think I didn't see you, bitch.
Ah! Oh, he missed me, by the way. He's not hurting me, but...
What? I'm kind of scared you grab that. Don't turn your back to them. Don't do that.
They're that way?
Yes!
For sure I saw one, bro. I looked at her, she looked at me, and we kissed.
Alright, let's go. Hey.
Fuck you, you pussy! Stay here!
Okay, fine, I'll stay.
Did you search a clue? You asshole!
Huh.
You searched a clue.
No, I just started banishing a scrap beat.
Oh, let's go for crap beat then. Alright, I made it very obvious that I'm here.
Oh my god, he's looking right at us.
Rush him. He misses every fucking shot. He barricaded it, that bastard! We climb. Ow, I'm getting shot in the back.
Yeah, you're gonna die. Sorry, buddy.
No, I'm not. I'm awesome. Ah!
That fucking one guy that had the whole ass fucking upper hand coming out there and staring at
me. That was me, dude. That was me from a different timeline.
Door is open.
This door is also open.
He's got a crossbow, so careful of that.
Yeah, well, I have nothing really. I have fusies! Oh shit, hold on, I thought they blinded me. Also, how did I. Well, I almost stepped in that poison. Fuck.
He's got fucking explosive rounds? That fucking piece of shit. That fucking piece of shit.
I think we traded! He point blanked me! Dude! Kirk!
What's up?
You know what just fucking happened?
What happened?
This guy point blanked me! And a barbed wire zombie hit him! The fucking poison trip mine hit him! And his own fucking shrapnel from his explosive fucking hit him! There's no way he's not dead. That was point fucking blank with three different things. Bleeding, poison, and fucking explosive. He has a barbed armor. Did it hit him? I heard it hit him. Oh, he got rezzed, I guess.
Yeah.
How's that a miss? These guys are immortal.
Oh, penny shot. That is fucked up.
And the explosive ammo, dude.
Oh, fuck. This is it. Game over.
They can see you. That explosive is gonna fucking kill you. If they push you, you'd be dead right now.
Yeah.
They're not that smart. Here comes the fucking explosive bow, though. Penis shot. Uh-oh. Kirk poison! Holy shit, dude, they had that shit set up, and we just missed every single one. Immediately. Oh, not that one, though. Oh, bad push. Nope, teammate. Oh, what the fuck was that? What just happened?
I went to go stop bleeding, and then he fucking jumped out. I wasn't expecting
you that. You had him dead to rights right there.
Yeah, yeah, I did.
Him.
I fucking did.
The Romero hatchet is the Romero hand cannon, but with an axe head at the tip of the barrel. It's the most badass looking Romero, in my opinion. You can one-hit hunters in the torso with your heavy melee. Your light melee only does 90 damage though, so I would stick to killing AI with it. Your sway actually improves too. I'm guessing because of the weight up front, your cycle time decreases by half a second. With that, I want to play with Seth some more.
Obsessed with it. Obsessed. Is that the Alaskan Contradiction Spider, dude? Holy moly!
The Alaskan Contradiction Spider.
Oh my god, it's real. Is that the... Oh my god, it's the Australian Armistice Spider! Holy shit!
Australian Armistice Spider.
It's right above me, isn't it? Spider armor, dude.
Oh shit, dude, that's terrifying.
Were you guys above us? Could you please get off my roof? Please get off my roof, please. My view.
You're up here with me? What the f- I hit a guy. Oh fuck, Seth, he's up here still. Good. Yeah! What's happening?
He stuck me with a sticky bomb, I was dead. But his teammate was right behind me. Right over there.
Trade!
I'll take it, man.
I know he's fucking screaming over that one, dude. I killed him!
A talon kill is not a hatchet right. Kill, so I have to keep going.
I'm done with that game, Kirk. I'm off. Too many L's in a row really defeats a guy, you know?
Fine.
myself.
Yeah, yeah.
After Seth left, I took on the bayou alone once again.
If I had any sort of range right now, these guys would be easy pickings. It's unfortunate.
At the lair, I met another hunter, who I think was a solo.
I just had a fucking sit there and watch as I clicked the fucking joint over and over. I got banned.
Thursday.
Good
I killed him and went after the other team.
What the fuck? Right in front of me? I didn't see her? Are you kidding?
Last variant. Romero Alamo is a variant that adds a neat reloading contraption, kind of sort of turning it into a semi-auto weapon. Cycle time between shots decreases by over a second, but your fire rate is actually slower. This is because reloading the contraption takes forever, almost 20 seconds. Be fully loaded before you fight somebody, please. I should also note that you can only bring one type of special ammo with this gun instead of the normal two. The gun is almost 100 hunt bucks, and whether or not that's worth it is up to personal preference. Personally, I think it's a fair price. I took him to a solo game, traded with a hillbilly, and headed back to Scrap Peak. I met two other hunters there and killed one of them. Went up a ladder and got demolished by another shotgun user. Place some traps on me, but guess what? Solar Resonance Necro for the win. I ran away and was gonna extract, but I decided I'd rather fight them, so I went back. And I won.
You suckers.
My next game was even better, but before I went in, I had to pick up one final thing, slug ammo. All this does is turn your buckshot into a single steel ball, meaning you could one-shot hunters at damn near twice the range. It doesn't become a rifle by any means, but if you want more distance to play with, bring it with you. Alright, so in my final game, I spawned a few compounds away from the assassin. And when I got there, a team was already fighting him. I snuck in, reamed a kid, and died to the boss. I mean, goddamn. That assassin double pumped me. After I heard somebody else die, I decided to wake up. The assassin and I tag-teamed this dude. I'm sorry, but this assassin seems way more aggressive than normal. I mean, are you fucking kidding me? I revive again and put that bitch down. After banishing, I get melee rushed. He gets necroed and I win again. He gets necroed again and I win. Again. I'm sorry. People not learn? Before his teammate decides to revive him for a third time, I go and finish the duo off. After grabbing the bounty, I scan and see another team. I took the opposite direction and got shot by another guy that I didn't see before. I ran from him too, and hit up a supply wagon. The duo from earlier shows up for some fun.
Holy shit. Oh. Wow.
I'm baffled.
Wake up, soldier. This fight is not finished.
Redemption arc, baby.
No, holy fucking shit. Holy fucking shit, dude.
8-kill game and we out this bitch. It's tier time, which means the weapons I use today are going to be judged on 4 criteria, based solely on my experience as a mid-hunt player. First off is its value. How well the weapon performs in comparison to its price. Second is the ability to kill. How often was I able to kill an enemy hunter with this weapon? 3 is its utilization. How useful is a weapon outside of PvP combat? And 4 is badassery. How badass do you look using this weapon? That's what I like to call the VAUB system, and it perfectly determines weapon's worth. If you don't like what the system has to say, then cry about it. The Romero 77 is an inexpensive choice with a high kill potential. It really is just a great shotgun. But the fact that it's single load is scary. You miss your shot and it can be the end of you. B tier. The Romero 77 hand cannon loses a lot in stats, but it still puts up a good fight. With it being a 2-slot weapon, you can bring a full rifle with you as well. I think that's a good trade-off. I'm putting it in B tier as well. Talon gives you hope if you miss your shot. It's a monster one hit kill swipe, and it's good for monster killing as well. It's just the normal Romero but improved, A tier. Just like the Talon, the hatchet opens new doors of opportunity that you don't get with the standard hand cannon, also A tier. Romero Alamo was a tough decision to make. It is nice to have an automatic reload, but you don't save all that much time in the end. It's still nice to have, but it's the most expensive and you only get 1 ammo slot. It's a high B. The VAUB system hereby states that the Romero 77 is... bussin'! There you have it. If you have any tips or things you'd like to add, please feel free to leave a comment. I plan to do more videos like this, so if you want to see more, consider leaving a like and subscribing. Thanks for watching, and keep it poppin'.